I'm Megan with Local News Now Update. Kids can sometimes feel like they're holed up at school for hours, but in one West Michigan school district, this could not be further from the truth.
To some students, school can be quite the challenge. But imagine a program that makes school feel a little less academic and a little more like home. The ARCH program in Kentwood Public Schools does just that. ARCH stands for Academics, Recreation, Community, and Health. It runs at 14 different Kentwood schools and allows students to focus on excelling at studies in the classroom and connects learning to their everyday lives.
And we've talked about things that normally kids don't get to talk about, like, I mean, gay marriage and like huge things that are out and critical in the society, but they don't get to talk about in school because they don't think they have a valued opinion.
ARCH caters to the bottom 30% of students in the school system, and site coordinator Brittany Bain says they carry an open dialogue with both parents and students.
Getting parents to believe, you got to get them to believe in the program, you got to get the kids to believe in the program.
Kids are also served lunch, snacks, and provided free transportation home if need be. In order for students to reap the benefits of ARCH, Bain says that it relies upon several factors, one of which is building a strong relationship between students and their leaders.
You're their teacher, and they need to know that you're there to be a support system for them when they don't have any, or to set rules, and even though sometimes they don't have rules at home.
At an age where students just want to be part of the crowd, one would think there would be little interest in hanging out in an after-school program. But Bain says otherwise. She explains that the students often know they need the extra help and are willing to take it.
FAIR isn't giving everybody the same thing. FAIR is giving kids what they need.
Students here at Crestwood Middle School say the program is helping them academically and socially. They say it's helping them reach goals that they didn't think were possible.
When I was in sixth grade, I wasn't the best as I wanted to be. And now this year, in seventh, I got to be on the honor roll.
Bain says even she notices students stepping up their game.
And I've just got the summer school list of kids that are failing that are going to be kind of invited to summer school. And we only have 6 or 7 kids from the ARCH program that are on there.
Between the educational learning and personal growth, there is one more important piece of advice.
It's all about them getting comfortable and knowing that they belong here.
For WKTV, I'm Megan Dooley.
Everybody loves an awards ceremony, at least I do. Recently, announcements were made for the Eclipse Award nominees, sponsored by WKTV with the West Michigan Film and Video Alliance. 48 unique entries were submitted for review by judges across the globe. The Eclipse Awards showcase the best in West Michigan's film, video, and television community. And Eclipse is awarded to locally produced media for outstanding work in the crafts and several primary categories. The mission of the Eclipse event is to inspire and enhance the West Michigan voice and mediums of television, film, sound, and web to be recognized for excellence among international, national, and regional judges. New this year is the Hyperion Award. It's the light behind the Eclipse, or better yet, the person behind the production community, setting an example by their craftsmanship, or pushing it forward, urging it on by their own example and creative energy. This year's winner is Deanna Morse, and the Hyperion Award is peer nominated from craftspeople working throughout the industry. Winners will be announced at the Eclipse Awards Ceremony Excellence in Craft Thursday, May 7th, and the Eclipse Awards Facebook page lists all of the nominees, or go to eclipseawards.com.
Opening day at Fifth Third Ballpark not only marked the start of a new baseball season for the West Michigan Whitecaps, but also a grand opening for the ballpark's craft beer clubhouse, a grand slam in the truest sense of the word. The new beer clubhouse is located along the third base concourse and offers a unique experience from the rest of the ballpark. While the stadium is built to play ball and escaping the weather is near impossible, the craft beer clubhouse offers a different atmosphere entirely. Inside the bar, it's set up much like Founders Brewery, a rustic feel with dim lighting to enhance a raw, relaxed feeling. And the bar is heated and air conditioning, so it's always open for business, no matter the weather. It's a huge bonus here in Michigan, where it can snow at a moment's notice. Now, the most important question, what does the Craft Beer Clubhouse have on tap? They currently have 16 local beers on tap from Perrin's, Bell's, Founders, Brewery Vivant, The Mitten Brewing Company, and Arcadia. It also offers wine and other mixed drinks. The early season response to the Craft Beer Clubhouse has been extremely positive, and it's been busier than all the other beer stands in the stadium combined. This spring and summer, make sure to check out the Whitecaps and maybe have a craft beer or two. I'm Mike DeWitt with Local News Now Update.